Good morning, friends. How are you? Welcome to Storytime. Are we ready to do our song? Here we go. Roll, roll, roll your hands fast as fast can be. Do it now, let me see. Do it now with me. Rub, rub, rub your tummy soft as soft can be. Do it now, let me see. Do it now with me. Clap, clap. Clap your hands loud as loud can be. Do it now, let me see. Do it now with me. Tap, tap, tap your toes soft as soft can be. Do it now, let me see. Do it now with me. Oh, good job, friends. Let's do our calendar. It is still the month of September. And today is Tuesday. Ooh, let's sing our day of the week song. You ready? Today is Tuesday. Today is Tuesday. All day long. All day long. Yesterday was Monday. Tomorrow is Wednesday. Let's have fun. Let's have fun. So, we follow the Tuesday all the way down here. We come to a 1 and a 5. A 1 and a 5 is a 15. So that makes today Tuesday, September 15th. Oh my goodness. So this week marks 6 months we've been doing story time on Facebook. Oh my goodness, I miss my friends so much. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 days in a week. Can you show me 7? Get your 7 days up there. There we go. There are 7 days. There are 7 days. There are 7 days in a week. There are 7 days. There are 7 days. There are 7 days in a week. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Yes, there are 7 days in a week, and today we are at Tuesday. There is our heart for today's story time. There is our heart for tomorrow's story time. And there on Friday is our heart for science time with Miss Abby. Next week, oh look, we've got Stories in the Park with the PRC. I hope you got registered for that. And then we've got next week's Story Times. The first day of fall, of autumn, a new season begins next week. It is feeling a lot like autumn, like fall out there right now. All right, so let's put our calendar over here. And let's check our weather. Do you want to look out your window or your door and check your weather? What's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather out today? What's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather out today? Oh, come back, my friends. What is the weather at your house this morning? I will tell you the weather at my house. It's very cloudy. I'm going to color in a rectangle on our clouds. Oh my goodness. I look up in the sky. All I see are clouds. That sun is trying to peek through, but right now it's just clouds. It's very cool outside. There's a little bit of a breeze. So there we go. There's our weather. All right, so do any of you recognize where I am today? We were out here in the spring when there were no leaves on the trees. There were just some flowers. We were out here in the summertime when there were those teeny tiny little green apples. And now we are out here in my orchard. Oh, what? There are some beautiful apples. Oh, there are some beauties. Let's see. Let me pick. but they are very tasty. I've been eating these apples. And guess what? This weekend, these apples will get made into cider. Ooh, yummy apple cider. So I have some apple stories today. So this first one, all about a little boy. Let me get my board out here. And let me get the little boy out here. So here is the little boy. Now this little boy, he is not looking very happy. He was bored. Oh, he was tired of playing with all his toys and his games and his puzzles. He was bored. So he went to his mom because his mom was great at coming up with adventures for this little boy. And he said to her, Mom, think of an adventure. I want to go on an adventure today. And his mom, oh, she had the perfect adventure for him. She said, I've got it. Why don't you go outside? Look for a little round house with no doors, no windows. This little round house has a chimney on top, and it has a star inside. Ooh, that did sound like a good adventure. So the little boy went out of the house and he started walking down the road on this adventure. Now, he didn't get far when he came to a young girl. And now the young girl asked him what he was doing outside on such a beautiful day. Was he out for a walk? And he says, well, my mom has sent me on an adventure. I'm looking for a little round house with no doors, with no windows. It has a chimney on top, and it has a star inside. She said, oh, I've never seen a house like that before, but maybe we can go and ask my father. He is very smart. So they went to the barn and found the girl's father. And the little boy looked at the farmer and said, excuse me, but my mother has sent me on this adventure. I'm looking for a little round house with no doors, with no windows. It has a chimney on top, and it has a star inside. Now the farmer looked at the boy and he said, I'm sorry, son, but I have no idea. I've never seen such a house before. Why don't you go ask my neighbor? She's very old and very wise. Okay, said the farmer. So the little boy, he kept walking on down the road where he came to the house of the very wise woman. And he walked up to her. She was sitting on her porch. And he said, excuse me, but I am looking for a little round house. It has no doors. It has no windows. It has a chimney on top, and it has a star inside. Do you know where I could find such a house? Now, the old woman said, oh, I've never heard of such a house, but why don't you go talk to the wind? The wind travels everywhere. Maybe the wind knows of such a house. Okay. So he went out into the road where he found the wind. Now the wind was blowing oh so gently, and the little boy looked up at the wind and said, wind, I am looking for a little round house with no doors, with no windows, a chimney on top, and a star inside. Do you know where such a house is, Mr. Wind? Well, now, of course, everyone knows the wind doesn't talk, but the wind blew just a little bit harder, and it blew the boy ever so gently into an apple orchard. And the boy looked up into that apple tree, and the wind blew ever so gently again, and it blew one of those apples right down, and the boy caught it in his hand. Now, as he looked at that apple, he said, ooh, doors. It has no windows. Ooh. There is a chimney on top. But is there a star inside? That boy very carefully took a pocket knife out of his pocket and very carefully he cut around that apple. And when he opened that apple up, guess what he saw? He opened up the apple and he saw, can you see it? Look at the star inside that apple. The little boy found it. The little round house with no doors, with no windows. A chimney on top and a star inside. Oh, isn't that so cool? And I promise you, this is not a trick apple. If you have an apple at home, you too, get a grown-up, cut it open this way, not this way, but cut it open this way. And when you look inside, you'll see the star inside your apple too. Oh, that's a great story. There we go. Oh, all right. So now this next story is also about an apple. It is about, let me get my apple tree out. There we go. There's the tree. And here is a little mouse. And here is the apple. One beautiful September day, Mouse decided to go for a walk. Oh, so Mouse, he was out walking through the beautiful countryside when all of a sudden he came to a tree. He looked up into that tree and way up at the tippy-tippy top of that tree, there was one red apple. Oh, Mouse looked at that apple and said, oh, that apple looks like it would taste so delicious. I'm going to sit right here and I'm going to wait for that apple to fall. And then I'm going to eat it. And that's exactly what he did. Mouse sat right down, right there at the base of the tree. And he just sat there and he watched that apple. He waited so patiently. Well, now, as he was waiting there, along came Hen. Now, Hen looked at Mouse and said, hey, Mouse, what you doing just sitting here? And Mouse said, well, look, Hen, up in the top of the apple tree. Oh, there's an apple. And I'm going to sit right here, and I'm going to wait for that apple to fall, and then I'm going to eat it. Well, Hen said, ooh, I like apples, too. Can I sit here and wait with you? And when that apple falls, we can share the apple? Sure, said Mouse. You sit right here, we'll wait. And yeah, I'll share that apple with you. Thank you, said Hen. And so Hen, she sat right down too, and she waited with Mouse. They waited for that apple to fall so they could share it. Well, now they waited. And they waited. Well, then along came Goose. Now, Goose saw Mouse and Hen sitting there, and Goose said, hello, Mouse. Hello, Hen. What are you doing just sitting here? And Mouse explained that, look up in the tree. There was one red apple left. And Mouse and Hen, we're going to sit right here. We're going to wait for that apple to fall, and then we're going to share it. And Goose said, oh, apples are my favorite. Can I wait here too? Well, sure, said Mouse. We will all wait here together. And when that apple falls, we'll share it. Oh, thank you, said Goose. So there they sat, Mouse and Hen and Goose. They all sat there and they waited for that apple to fall. Well, they waited. And they waited. And they waited some more. Well, then along came fall. And when it did fall out of the tree, they were going to share it. Oh, said Cow, I had a dream about an apple. Can I wait here too? Sure, said Mouse. We all wait here together. And when that apple falls, we'll share it. Well, thank you, said Cow. So they waited, and they waited, and they waited. Now, as they were waiting, along came Goat. Now, Goat saw them waiting too, and Goat said, hey, everybody, what are you doing just sitting here waiting? And Mouse explained again that they were waiting for the apple to fall out of the apple tree. And when the apple fell, they were going to share it. And Goat said, oh, I would love some apple. Can I wait? Sure, said Mouse. We will all wait here together. And when that apple falls, we'll share it. Well, thank you, said Goat. Okay, so they sat there. And they waited. And they waited. And they waited. Oh, they waited a really long time, but still, that apple did not fall out of the apple tree. Well, now Mouse waited very patiently. He sat there very still and just waited. But Hen and Goose and Cow and Goat, yeah, they didn't wait so patiently. They started to think of ways that they could make that apple fall. Hen said, oh, I know, I've got a really good idea. I will get a running start. I will run really fast, and then I'll flap my wings really hard, and I will fly up into that tree, and I will knock that apple down with my wing. So that's what Hen decided to do. She got a running start. She was running and running and running and flapping her wings really, really hard. All the while she's running and flapping her wings, she's looking at that apple. And because Hen wasn't watching where she was going, she tripped over a rock and she fell right on her beak. Ouch! Ooh! Oh, I hurt my beak. And still, the apple did not fall. Well, then Goose said, oh, no, I've got a really good idea. I'll honk really loud. That will make the apple fall from the tree. So Goose went right up underneath that apple. Goose looked right up at that apple, and she started to honk. She went, honk, honk, honk. And of course, that apple did not fall out of the tree. Jump up and down. That will make the apple fall. So Cow, she started to jump up and down. She'd jump in and jump in and jump in. And she watched that apple, and that apple, it wiggled and it wiggled and it wiggled. Oh, but it still did not fall down. And Cow said, oh, this jumping up and down, that made me tired. And Goat said, oh no, I've got a really great idea. I will run really fast, and I will hit the tree with my head. That will make that apple fall. So that's what Goat did. He got a running start. He was really fast, and then he hit that tree with his head. Boom! You know what I think? I think that that's a rotten apple. goose said, "I am tired of waiting for that apple to fall too." You know what I think? I think that that's probably a really sour apple. Blech! I don't like sour apples. I'm going home. So, and then Hen, she said, "I am tired of waiting for that apple to fall too." I think that that apple is probably all soft and mushy. Blech! I don't like soft and mushy apples. I'm going home. So then Hen went home. And look who's left. Just Mouse. And Mouse sat there and he waited so patiently. He waited all day long. And finally, it was starting to get dark. The sun was going down and it was almost dark. When all of a sudden a little wind came along and it blew that apple out of the tree and it landed right there at Mouse's feet. And Mouse, he picked up that apple and he looked at it. It didn't look rotten. It didn't look like it was full of wormholes. Yeah, didn't look all soft and mushy. Munch, munch, munch. Who could that be? Oh, look. One, two. Now there's only two. Two red apples hanging in a tree. I ate one. Oh, yes, I did. Yes, it was me. Now look. Now there's only one apple. There's just one red apple hanging in a tree. Guess what? Willie the worm ate that one, you see. And now look. Now there's zero apples hanging in the tree. Oh, next spring, we better call the honeybees. Oh, all right, let's do one more quick apple. Ready? It's about a worm, too. Here is a yellow apple, there's a red apple, and there is a green apple. And look, there's a worm. Guess what? The worm is going to hide under one of these apples. Close your eyes while I hide the worm. look under the green apple. Let's see. No worm there. Wiggly worm crawling on the ground. Beneath which apple can you be found? Oh, shall we look under the yellow apple? Let's see. Nope. No worm under the yellow apple. Do you think it's under the red apple? Wiggly worm crawling on the ground. Beneath which apple can you be found? Oh, let's see. There is that wiggly little worm. He was in the red apple. Yeah, I really don't like apples that have worms in them. How about you? Do you like wormy apples?
Mm-mm, not me.
All right, my friends, it is time for us to say goodbye. Make sure you have your adult put in the comment section how many of you are watching. Remember, if there are 3 kids and 1 grown-up watching, how many does that make? 3 and 1 are 4. Good job. All right, and sing the goodbye song with me. You ready? My hand says goodbye. My hand says goodbye. Every time I leave my friends, my hand